About knowing a bit more about Jesus Christ. Everything's open to interpretation. What can I say? Got music as well. Rap, hip hop, acoustic. So it will help you a lot. Take your mind off all the things of the world. Get you focused on God, on Jesus Christ. He is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the judge of the earth. His name means salvation. Hallelujah. What is salvation? Salvation is victory, I suppose. Salvation is being with God. Salvation is having eternal life. Salvation is many, many different things. A lot of people just limit God to what's in this world. But Jesus said, I am not of this world. If I was of this world, I'd fight against, you know, whoever it was at the time, the Roman soldiers. But Jesus knew that he had to go to the cross and die for the sins of Israel and of all mankind. But when he returns again, he returns as the judge of the earth, the all-conquering king, the lion of the tribe of Judah. And the nations will go into judgment against the king of heaven. And so at this point, I'll be questioning, what is salvation? Do I know Jesus? Do I understand why he came, who he is? These questions are very, very important. Sometimes I go through the holy books, such as the Bible, such as the Quran, such as the Vedas, to explain to you who Jesus is and why he had to die for your sin. Because if he didn't die for your sin, you couldn't get salvation. The Bible says, unless there's the shedding of blood, then there's no atonement for sin. Hallelujah. Unless it's a shedding of blood, there's no atonement for sin. That's what Jesus did 2,000 years ago. That is the gospel in a nutshell. And if you believe that, you believe who Jesus is, the King of Kings, who came and died for your sin, you ask him into your life, it says you'll be sealed unto the day of redemption with the Holy Spirit. That's what the Bible says. If you believe, you receive. But it's not this easy believism when we switch on the God channel about, you know, I want to have a big house, I want to have earn $100 million a year. That's not what the Bible is. That's what it's presented as in the God channel. But salvation is eternal life. Salvation is a free gift of God that seals your soul unto the day of redemption. And so there's a lot of false prophets. Joel Osteen says, when you become a Christian, you have your best life now. But Jesus Christ said, when you follow me, you shall have trials and tribulation. Joel Osteen says that when you become a Christian, you don't suffer. Jesus Christ says, blessed are those who suffer for righteousness' sake. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And so whatever gospel that these guys are preaching, I don't know what it is. But Jesus is the way, the truth, the life. No man comes to God except through him. Very, very simple. If you say you know God, you don't have the Son, you're making out the Messiah to be a liar. You're making out yourself to be sinless. Which in the Epistle of John, 1 John, it says, unless you admit that you have sin, that you're a liar and the truth is not in you. So I'm the first one here to admit I'm a sinner. God bless you, sir. God bless. I'm the first one here to admit that I'm a sinner. You know, I don't believe in sinless perfection unless, you know, Jesus is standing right in front of me or whatever. But I do believe in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. When you're born again, a man is born again, is baptized into the power of heaven, the Spirit of heaven, which is called the Holy Spirit. That's what Jesus came to do. He didn't come to just build a nice little church so you could attend that nice little church and all that stuff. He came to make you the church. He came to make you a son of the living God. That's what he came to do. It's up to you if you want that or not. If you understand what that is or not. Then he came to give us a religion. We've already got about, I think it's 40 odd thousand religions. We don't need religion. What we need is salvation. We need God. A few people came and spoke to me today and acknowledged that they felt empty the past few weeks. That inside their soul, they know that something's missing. Something's missing deep down inside of them. He thought it was money, he thought it was having a girlfriend or whatever. And he got these things and he's still something missing in his life. It's God. It's the Holy Spirit. You know, when God created Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve, by the way, created Adam and Eve, right? And he created them for perfect fellowship and to create children as well. But also so that God could have fellowship with them as well. Perfect harmony with God's creation and with God himself. But we've fallen out of fellowship with God. We've chosen to go our own way. According to Isaiah 53, all of us like sheep have went our own way. We've went astray from the ways of God. And this is how the second Adam, Jesus Christ, came. To not only bridge the gap between man and God, but to give us salvation through his Spirit, through the Holy Spirit. Yes, God is spirit, it says in the Bible. No man has seen the Father, no eye has seen God, but it describes God as spirit as well. And there can only be one Messiah, one way back to God, and that is the man, the Son of God, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. It is a mystery, but it's been revealed in the last days to us. You know, all these prophets and all these holy men wrote down the various prophecies about the coming of the Messiah, how he would come, how he would be born, the things he would do, the fact he'd be rejected by his brothers, just like Joseph was. If you want to understand who the Messiah is, read about what happened to Joseph. Joseph was rejected, he was sold into slavery. You know, apparently he faked his death and then he was in prison. But then later on, he was exalted to Pharaoh's right hand. Just like Jesus, when he died, exalted to God's right hand. Very, very similar story. And you look at all the stories about the righteous men that God accepted. They made sacrifices of a lamb, like Abel did, like Abraham did. You know, just at the last moment, he was going to sacrifice Isaac, which meant if he did that, there'd be no Jacob, there'd be no Israel. It's interesting, but there'd be no line of the Messiah if he actually sacrificed Isaac, but according to the Bible. But at the last moment, God says, behold, a lamb. And he took that lamb and he sacrificed that lamb. So all of these stories point to who Jesus is and what he came to do. John the Baptist, when Jesus appeared on the scene, he said, behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the whole world. Say, you come to me to be baptized, but of you I need to be baptized. And so what the Bible teaches is, first, a man must be born of water, which is a baptism of water of John, of repentance, and then the baptism of the Messiah, the baptism of the Spirit of God. And so you say you love God, you say you have religion, but you do not listen, you do not respect Jesus Christ, you don't follow after the Messiah? Come on. God is not fooled. So it's your choice. You can continue in your sin. Jesus said, unless you believe that I am He, the Son of God, the Messiah, then you shall die in your sin. So it's up to you. You want to die in your sin and see what happens? Take that lottery. It's up to you. But as far as I understand, God is real and He speaks through His Word. Jesus Christ is His Word. According to the Quran, according to the Bible, that's what Jesus is described as, the Word of the Living God. And so do you believe God's Word, or do you reject God's Word? Very, very simple. Simple choice. Yeah, we all have to make that choice. Make the right choice. I believe in the movie Trainspotting, it says, choose life. Well, I'm saying choose Jesus. Jesus is the King of life. Jesus is salvation. So if you choose Jesus, you actually choose life. You choose eternal life if you choose Jesus. It's better than just life. Eternal life means you shall live forever, experience God's Spirit, God's presence, God's healing, God's anointing, God's peace. You want these things in your life? Choose Jesus. If you don't want them, keep on arguing with yourself, arguing with whoever. You know, have religion. Doesn't really give you peace. Think Buddhism makes you feel good about yourself. It gives you, you know, they talk about levitation and all that stuff. I've spoke to a lot of people on drugs that think they levitate, do you know what I mean? So what's all that about? The book of Proverbs, verse 31 says, who has descended and who has ascended? What is his name and what is his son's name, if you can tell? That's Proverbs 31, verse 4. Lots of little verses in the Bible that speak about God having a son. And only Jesus came down. Only Jesus was the one who descended from heaven. And then when he died, he was resurrected, then he ascended again back into heaven. So Jesus is his name. His Father's name is Yahweh. So I can answer that question because I'm born again. I know Jesus Christ. I'm not ignorant to the ways of God. I've chosen life. I've chosen Jesus. According to the Bible, I'm sealed unto the day of redemption. I don't need to worry about where my soul is going when I die. Every single one of us will die. Everyone is going to die and face God. So whatever vain thing that you believe in, it's only going to last in your life. Whatever idol it is that you exalt, whatever way of life that you put before God, you say, I'm just going to live my life my way. You're going to have to face God one day. So choose carefully. If you pray, pray to the creator of the universe. Don't pray to an idol, pray to the creator of the universe. Address him as the creator. Address him as your father. That's what Jesus came to say. Came to teach humanity that our father is the one in heaven. Hallowed be his name. His kingdom come, his will be done over your kingdom, over the kingdoms of the world. On earth as it is in heaven. Heaven is perfect. Earth is fallen. Earth is not perfect, in case you haven't noticed. It's a lot of wickedness on the earth. Heaven is perfect. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Jesus also said his blood atones for your sin. Do you bless your food before you sit down and eat it? Do you know that every good thing comes from God? Are you aware God created the food for the farmers to harvest? The few animals, he created these animals. He told Moses which animals they could eat. Be aware, everything you have is from God. Even the beer you drink is from God. The hops and the barley, all from God. But depends how you use them. It also says, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Jesus said, if you want to have mercy, you must obtain mercy. You must show mercy to obtain mercy. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Believe me, some of us, a lot of people owe me money. I gotta forgive them. You might be a creditor or a debtor or whatever. So you gotta show forgiveness if you want God to forgive you of the many sins you've done against him. He says, lead us from or not into temptation. If you're following Jesus, he's not going to lead you into temptation. So the next line is, lead us not into temptation. If you've been tempted, questionably, are you following Jesus or are you just following the ways of the flesh? Sometimes God allows us to be tempted, to test us. You know, Satan will come along. Here's, try this alcohol, try these drugs, you know. Have lots of girlfriends, whatever. That's what Satan does. He comes and tests us, but we got to rebuke him. Some of us don't rebuke Satan. We say, come on in. Let's have a fast drink. Let's take drugs and do whatever. But you got to rebuke that type of spirit. Some of us don't. And it also says the last thing is deliver us from evil. So Jesus talks about the prince of this world being the evil one, and Jesus says for you to pray every day, deliver us from evil. And then finally he says, for thine is thy kingdom, the power and the glory, forever, amen. So he's venerating the Father, he's venerating God for all the good things that he wants to give you. He wants to give you good things in your life. Be just like a soldier, you're not going to win the battle unless you have a level of discipline. Discipline is a key. If you want to be blessed from God, you've got to walk in the ways of God. Allow Jesus to lead you, anoint you, bless you. As soon as you fall into temptation, the devil came to lie, steal, and destroy. And he's doing that to a lot of people. Don't allow him to do it. Don't allow Satan to lie to you, steal from you, and destroy your life and health. Jesus said, don't fear the one who can kill the body, but fear the one who can both kill the body and the soul, destroy the soul in hell. The book of Isaiah talks about a place of punishment that sinners go to. Well, this question, is God a righteous God? God is a righteous God. That's why he won't allow unrighteous sinners into his kingdom, but he also punishes wickedness. He does it. He punishes wicked people. So just think all the people that you watch, maybe the murderers and Adolf Hitler, I don't know, all these people, Jimmy Savile, who do you think he is? in the fires of hell right now being tormented, as the Bible says, because God is a righteous judge. That's where he is, and that's where he'll remain for all eternity for the sins he's committed against God. God is a righteous God. But just the same, there's people in hell that they've really not done that much wrong. But all they've not done is follow Jesus, just accepted Jesus Christ into their life. Very, very simple to do. It's a choice that we all have. Jesus said there's no way to the Father except through him. A man must be born again to inherit the kingdom of God. Jesus is not going to retract his words for you because you don't want to follow him, you don't want to read a Bible, you don't want to understand who Jesus is from the Quran or the Bible or the Vedas. You just want to put it to the side and have a religion. It's up to you. God will judge you one day. You'll regret it. You know. Hallelujah. It says in the Bible, God is love. God is patient. He wants all men to humble themselves and repent of their sin. He loves you, thank you. He loves you very, very much. He's patient, he's waiting for you just to repent and come to him. He doesn't want you to end up in hell. I will do. He doesn't want you to end up in hell. That's my point. God is love. So love is, if you want somebody of a future event that could harm you, or let's say for example you're driving down a road and the bridge is collapsed. Now, unless you stop and warn other drivers, these drivers could end up over the bridge dead. So it's love that warns people. So it's like that with your soul. A lot of street preachers got a lot of flack. Why are you out here preaching the gospel? Why? Because I don't know where you could end up. Do you know where you're going to end up? Really? None of us are guaranteed a tomorrow, or tomorrow, or next week, or next month. We don't know what's going to happen to us. The Bible says if you die without Jesus Christ, you go to hell. Simple. So you've got to make a choice. Make a choice. Choose life. As Trainspotting says, but choose the King of life, who is Jesus Christ. Choose the King of kings, the Lord of lords. Don't choose death. Don't choose to turn your nose up to God and say, I don't need you. I'm righteous in my own eyes. I'm my own little demigod. I don't need you. Really? Did you create yourself? Did you bring yourself into existence? What about the food you're eating now? Did you create it? What about the dust of the earth that the scientists are always doing experiments on and saying, well, we can do all the things God can do. God's the one that created the dirt and the earth and everything you see around you. God's the creator. You see, there is a designer. Hallelujah, could go on. I've got free flyers if you want to study a little bit more about Jesus, what's going on, prophecy. I'm also giving music out as well. I do rap, hip hop and acoustic. So very welcome to have one of those as well. Take it away. Because as you can tell, I've got a lot to say. Give the testimony if you know Jesus. Give Jesus a shout. Do you love him? You love Jesus? Praise the Lord. I'd love to be a reggae man. I'd love, that's the only music I can't do, but I'd love to do that.
You do the best
that you can,
trust me.
I do my best. Yes, I do my best. So, where are you from? Poland, wow, one of my favorite places. I've never been there. Jesus is the Son of God, he is God, he's the Word of God. Yep. Nothing would be here except if it wasn't for Jesus. According to the Gospel of John, 1 John. In the beginning was God, the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus is God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Doesn't take a rocket scientist to work that out, but, you know, a lot of people. I've just been reading out the Quran as well. Yeah, read out the Quran, Surah 19, Surah 3, Surah 5, all talking about Jesus' death and resurrection in the Quran. Amazing. There's actually, I believe there's one Islamic group that venerate Jesus more than they do any other prophet. I'm not sure if they accept his death on the cross, but again, I know a bit of history about that as well.